Beautiful buddies, welcome back. For working on my save file, Veronaville. We're working on the Monty house. It's obviously different from like the other English style homes in the world in this from The Sims 2 into The Sims 4. If you notice like in some videos that I'm like happen to wear like the same shirt, like sometimes re-record my, you know, intros. And I'm also kind of new to face cam, so like be nice to me if I'm like sometimes like awkwardly like looking the other direction or something like that. I'm trying to get better at this, but yeah, you guys can let me know too if you guys even like the little face cam here and there. Yeah, you can let me know and I will see you guys like in the video.
Welcome, welcome. We are back here with the Monty household. Like I said in the beginning, if you are new to the channel or you don't really have much experience with past Sims games, basically the Monty family was a family in Veronaville from The Sims 2, and it basically kind of took a lot of Shakespeare inspired families and stories and basically made it into an entire town. This household is obviously inspired by Romeo and Juliet. This is like the Montague household, but they call them the Montys. And they have like this really, really awesome like Mediterranean home, like inspired Mediterranean home. And I hope I did it justice because I feel like this one was definitely different than anything I think I've built on the channel so far. Just like the style of it, and actually no, not the style of it. I have done this house before. If you guys watched when Seasons came out, I did like in a Mediterranean style house when I did the Bratz house, but nothing like this. This was definitely its own lane. I really, really loved how it has like all these archways to like walk in, like around like the corridors. It was definitely different. It was cool. Like I always do for my save file, I do like to put on my own little spin with the build. Like the front of this house, I believe in The Sims 2, had like just a front gate, which personally I didn't like that. I kind of wanted a more grand entrance, so I closed off the front of it and like made this like big beautiful door, even though it's like, well, it's like you're bunch of archways, so like what's the point? I just for the aesthetic of it, guys, just for the aesthetic. And I like to think too, like there would maybe be like glass in these archways or something like that if this was like a real house, just because like I'm sure you just wouldn't want anyone just like walking through your house. But yeah, this is a sim, so it doesn't matter, but it's just really interesting, really cool, really pretty. And I also put a glass roof over like the courtyard area in the middle, just because you guys wanted me to go ahead and do Veronaville in Windenburg, which I definitely agree. I think Windenburg has a really beautiful like European flair to it, and it goes really, really well with Veronaville's like English side of it. But with that said, it does get like cold here in the winter, so it isn't exactly like palm tree weather like the build is in originally. And I still put some palm trees because like it's Veronaville and like, you know, the Mediterranean side did, but I think they like flow well with the fact that like it's on an island and like the lots on that island are kind of like dispersed, so they doesn't like look like a real cohesive like neighborhood like some of the other worlds do. But I am so, so happy to have it be that way, because then I could actually put the palm trees and it looks a little bit more natural. But with that said, what was I saying? Oh, that I feel like this world fits a little bit better by me splitting up the different types of builds. So like I'm having the side that I built the cap on to be more English like house inspired, like the original Windenburg was, and then the island and like where all the modern builds were to be a little bit more Europe, like more the European Mediterranean style. And I hope you guys liked my furnishing too, and the glass roof on top of this house, just because like I said, I like to update it. I like to make it more modern, more functional if you guys actually want to play in these homes. And like it'd be a shame to like just not be able to play in this in the wintertime just because, like, your Sims are always putting on their cold weather outfits or, like, freezing to death or something like that. So I, like, solve that problem so they can be outdoors even when it's indoors, I guess. And yeah. Also, too, I did build this originally on the Vitreals, whatever their name is, from Windenburg, and I did keep their backyard mainly the way that it originally was, with, like, different landscaping, just because I really liked how it fit. Like, it fit really well, I feel like, with this home, and I was like, even though, no, the home didn't have, like, a big grand pool and, like, all those outdoor activities from The Sims 2, I figured that, like, you know, like, why not put them, like I said, like, this is meant to be, like, yes, a recreation of, like, old Sims games, like, towns, but they're, like, meant to be updated. Like, they're meant to have, like, a little facelift, you know, they're meant to be in 2020, 2021, and I just think that's, you know, that's just the way it goes. And plus, too, it's so many save files these days, because, I did start my save file when it was, like, a fairly more new and original idea, but I feel like now a lot of people are making save files, and I think it's really important to be, like, you know, like, why are you gonna download, like, my save file, you know? So, like, mine has its own special little spin, so even if someone wanted to do a similar idea to me, you have, you know, the reason why you're picking mine, because it has a little something extra and a little something special, and I hope you like that. But with that said, I am going to create the households, like, the main three. I have one more main build to do after this one, and it is the Summer Dream household, as far as, like, the main house lots. The rest of them I will, like, fill up from, like, Sims with the Simbin around the town and, like, NPCs, and then I'm gonna move on to some, whatchamacallit, venue builds, and I'm, like, thinking about what venues I want for Veronaville, so if you guys have any suggestions, put them down below. I like to rename the different, like, restaurants and, like, nightclubs and things like that, from, like, the sub-neighborhoods of The Sims 2, so that's kind of where the vibe is, I think, but I like to reimagine them. Like, I don't like to do the exact same layout for, like, venues from The Sims 2, just because I have to be honest, they were really basic and mainly boring, and I feel like, for example, like, I did a nightclub for Pleasant View, and it's still to this day is one of my favorite venue builds. It's called The Pure Nightclub, so it's inspired by that nightclub from The Sims 2. You can probably go and check it out on my channel and, like, my, Rebuilding Pleasant View, like series. So yeah, like, I'm still thinking about what lots I want to do. I think I'm probably gonna stick to, like, the same type of lots that Windenburg already has, but I think I'll maybe add a restaurant instead of having two cafes. I don't know. You guys can let me know if there's any, like, lots you for sure want to see, in my version of Veronaville, in the comments section down below. I'm also thinking, too, that I would love, I think, to get back into streaming, because it's been quite a long time since I've properly streamed, and I think I've kind of gotten to that point in quarantine, whatever, the pandemic, that I would like to try something a little bit new, just because, yeah, I just feel like something new for the channel, I guess, would be good for me. I'm not sure if I'm gonna do it on Twitch first, or, like, YouTube, because ultimately, I feel like Twitch is probably better for the long term, but yeah, I don't know if I would like to do, like, a couple of, like, YouTube streams just to get, like, my feet wet into it, just because YouTube seems more chill to stream on than, like, Twitch does. Like, I feel like Twitch is, like, people that know what they're doing for streaming, but it doesn't necessarily have to be that way, I guess. I shouldn't think that way, because I have streamed before on it. It's just been a while, and yeah, I just feel like it'd be something fun to do for, like, you know, like, the houses that aren't necessarily, like, the townhomes and things like that, and like venue builds. I feel like it's a different way for us to bond, and for us to like grow our little family, because I really do think people that stream oftentimes have success rate on their videos and things like that because people come from their streams. Maybe they come and watch your videos. So let me know if that's something you guys would like, or if you guys are the opposite, if you guys watch my videos and would like to come to my streams. Because yeah, I've been thinking about that more and more and more, and I'm like, you know, like, what's stopping me from doing it? But also too, I think it's also too, I have to figure out like what times people actually like to watch streams and things like that. Because typically for me, I like it to watch streams in the evening, but I know that's not always everybody, so you guys would have to let me know, like, what's your ideal time, your ideal day to, like, watch a stream? Like, when do you usually find yourself for, like, doing it with other people, like, watching it with other people? But yeah. Okay, going back to the build, I cut out so much material, guys, from this build, so much material, and I still feel like there is still a lot of good material in it. That's the funny thing, like, this build took me a while, took me a lot of love, it took me a while to do, and I really love the detailing that you guys will probably see that I put in this build, because I went in the gallery and I searched up you know, like, artwork that your Sims actually could make and put it into the build, just because I wanted something extra, you know? I wanted this build to be full of life. It's something extra, like that extra mile. Because I always appreciate it when I go into save files and I see that extra detailing, like if someone put like family photos or you know, like just the debug art and things like that. Like, I appreciate it because I feel like it gives your build like more life, and you can tell who lived there. Sorry, there's like a piece of like eraser mark or something like that on my keyboard. I have no idea. Anyway, moving on from that little blurb. Yeah, I love it, and I think the artwork behind the two boys' bed, Romeo and his brother, Mercutio, or whatever his name is, I think, I think I need to, like, brush up on, like, the whole, backstory and things like that, and stuff like that for Ronaville, and just, like, in general, because, I kind of need to, like, brush up on like what they like and things like that, because often when I build these houses, I will look in their Sim profiles to things that their interests are, because The Sims 2 works differently than The Sims 4. But it's like after I build it, I forget a little bit. I'm not gonna lie. And I definitely need to do that for when I do the create a Sim, because I've been kind of like doing this thing like where I'm like, I'm gonna do the builds all at once and then do the create a Sims. And yeah, I'm honestly feel like Ronaville is definitely probably the longest one probably it will take, just because I feel like Windenburg is so large and in charge. But I'm hoping that it will be a success, like people will want to download this one because I'll have put so much effort into it. And Windenburg is personally one of my favorite worlds, so I don't mind at all. As you could tell too, I used a lot of the new paranormal stuff, like the new plants and things like that, just because I thought they looked so beautiful on this build. Especially that like potted palm tree one. I believe in The Sims 2 we had one just like it, and I love it. I was like, it couldn't have came at a more perfect time. And yeah. Also too, this is a weird question for you guys, but out of all the debug paintings that you guys could find, which one is your favorite that your Sims can paint? Personally, I have a couple that I really like. One of them is actually in the parents' bedroom in this build. And it's the one that reminds me of Lady in the Tramp. The Little Mermaid, like when she's on the boat, and like basically, you know, in the movie when like the crab like sings like, "Oh, just kiss the girl, sha-la-la-la-la-la, by your mind." You know which one I'm talking about. I can't do his accent very well. The crab. His name is Sebastian, not the crab. I really like that one. I just think it's so cute because it always reminds me of the Little Mermaid. And I also really like this one where I think it's a confident painting, I'm not sure, but it's just like this woman with sunglasses and she has like all the swirlies on them. I didn't find that in the debug art painting that I was looking for, but honestly, I don't feel like it would fit this build anyway, but that's another one of my favorites. Also too, I like the Mona Lisa version of the painting in this game. Like they have like their own basically version of Mona Lisa, and it's really cute. I actually seen Mona Lisa in person once. It was a lot smaller than I expected it to be, funny enough. But yeah, now I just sound like a snob, to be honest. Like, oh, you got to see it. Shalala. Anyway, also too, I used that hot tub that we got last year for The Sims 20th birthday. Now, some people probably hate that. They just like want to chuck it out the window because it's like all we got. But honestly, that was like the first time I think I ever used that hot tub in particular. And honestly, I couldn't have found a more perfect spot for the hot tub, to be honest. Also too, I guess I should point out that I moved the original placement of the staircase. So there is a staircase going up from the outside of the build in The Sims 2, but I didn't like that. I put it in the corridor, like the hallway going to there, because it just made more sense to me. So I hope you guys like don't mind that. I hope you guys don't mind that at all. And of course too, we gotta have our clutter, because these boys in their sim profile were messy. And I believe when you open your game, first open it in The Sims 2, that they had like garbage everywhere. So I was like, okay, we're gonna put like fake dirty clothes. Just because, you know, like if you have like the real dirty clothes, then your sims will have to wash them and they'll get like the stink piles and things like that. So, you know, like the clutter one is the best for the aesthetic of it, and for your sims just like not to stink. But yeah, I really do feel like the Sims, for stuff pack, they really should look into doing like maybe like a teen stuff pack. I feel like that would go well. We have a toddler one, we have a kids one. I feel like the teens need a little love too. You know what I mean? Yeah, I think I do. I think they do. But ultimately too, I'm really holding out for a generations pack this year. Like so many people, I feel like that's just like what we need. We need to give the people what they need this year. I feel like that'd be good. So Sims team, if you're watching, I completely doubt it, but because this isn't like a review or anything, we need a generations pack like really badly. And yeah, just because like we all want one, it isn't just a me thing. So please give it to us. Thank you very much. But yeah, we're coming to like towards the end of the build now. So yeah, let me know guys down below if you guys would like to come to a stream, like what times you usually like a stream. I'm not like making any promises right now. I'm just like collecting some data and things like that. And just like, you know, just thinking about it. You know, I'm just thinking about it, girl. I'm not gonna do it, you know. You know that meme. If you don't, then I guess you don't, but I think most people know what I'm referring to if you're like into like the meme culture on Twitter. But yeah, you can let me know that down below, as well as what venues would like to see in Veronaville going forward. And make sure you guys put all of your love down below. I want to see all your lovely little comments. You guys have been a little shy lately. I want to see your views. I want to see your likes. And yeah, I hope you guys have a wonderful, wonderful week, and I will speak to you soon. Also too, it's Valentine's Day when I'm recording this. So if you're celebrating Valentine's Day, whether you're with someone or alone, I hope you've had a wonderful day, and I will speak to you soon. Okay, bye bye bye. We'll spend nights cheap red wine, look at flats even though we can't afford them. I don't want to let you down, I don't want to lose.
question now. Will you stay, even when you wanna walk away? When times get bad, we can learn to love what we have.
I don't wanna let you down.